All right, so this is the Hooker Valley track in the Mount Cook National Park.
Yes.
How long's the track?
12 kilometres.
Yeah, they say it takes about an hour and a half, I think.
Each way.
We're puffed already. Yeah. We've only been walking half an hour.
We've got a lovely sunny day, but it's very windy.
Yeah.
It's actually 3 hours.
3 hours. There you go, Mr. Maths down there. So there's apparently a bunch of swing bridges along the way. There's a lake that sometimes has icebergs in it up the top.
Don't think there is at the moment.
Yeah.
No icebergs, but we'll see.
Just a beautiful walk apparently, and hopefully today, because we don't have much cloud, we'll see Mount Cook, fingers crossed, because it's normally hidden in cloud, so yeah, we'll go for a wander. So Chelsea and I have actually attempted this track in the past.
Yes, we came all the way out here and a massive storm rolled through.
Yeah, we sat in the caravan. There's a campground here I'll show you later on, but we sat in the caravan
rocking around for a day.
And we didn't get outside. So pretty stoked. It's very windy and that's why I haven't been talking to you too much, sorry. But yeah, little spots like this that are sheltered.
Yeah.
Nice day so far.
Beautiful views.
Yeah. Chelsea's just coming off the back of a cold and so are the twins. So.
And Harvey.
Yeah. It's going to be well worth the effort, I think, but yeah, a bit tiring. So behind me is the second of three, apparently, swing bridges along the way. Pretty incredible bridges. The water here is like this weird grey blue sort of colour, I'm guessing because of all the rock and everything, but pretty amazing. The track is like really well maintained as well, so yeah, pretty easy going. Alright, I'm just hiding in the bushes out of the wind, hopefully, but that behind me is Mount Cook, and we can see the top of it, which is pretty exciting. Covered in snow as well, which is amazing, seeing it's summer here, but maybe it's covered in snow all year round, I'm not sure. So we're going to continue up this valley, another swing bridge apparently, and then a lake, the Hooker Lake at the top of this valley, that sometimes has icebergs floating in the lake, which is pretty cool. So we'll head up there, see what we can find. Alright, this is a workout with these kids on our backs. A lot of the people that overtook us on the way here this morning, because we were dawdling with the kids, have now come back. So hopefully that means we're getting closer. Yeah, we've crossed the third bridge. There were toilets as well back there, which is cool. They looked really new. We thought it was a big rock when we first saw it, but it's actually two toilets. Sorry, get out of that wind. Kind of funny system as well for the toilets. There were like little carts, like mine carts with tanks on them. They rolled under the toilets. And when they're full, they roll them out the other side. So I'm guessing they helicopter all the waste out of here, which is pretty crazy, but cool that there's toilets in here. It's pretty amazing on this mountain behind me. There's some serious slips of rock. And apparently when you're camping here, you can hear them booming and avalanching at night. You see all the way up there, it's just slipped all the way down, and they're the whole way down this valley. Chelsea said it's on her bucket list here, an avalanche. So I mean, it'd be pretty cool to hear, but yeah, probably a bit scary at the same time when we're camping sort of just over there. All right, 5 minutes to go apparently, thank goodness. I should also point out, just for context, we are a week out from Christmas, and Auckland here in New Zealand, if you're not from New Zealand, Auckland's been in lockdown, and just got out of lockdown, so we figure this is a good time to get out and explore this sort of track. I can imagine peak summer, like pre-COVID, this would have been one busy track, I reckon. Probably seen 30, 40, 50 people on the track today, but yeah, it looks like it's made for some serious numbers. The car park looks like it's made for a lot of buses and things like that, so probably worth doing in like the off season or midweek or, you know, shoulder season or something like that. Well, it was very windy at the lake, but pretty neat, eh?
Yeah, we didn't stay too long because the girls' teeth were chattering.
Yeah, poor Piper was freezing. The wind just coming straight off the mountain and the glacier there, but kind of cool. I've never seen a lake with icebergs in it, so
yeah,
there you go. That's a first. Even if the icebergs were dirty and covered in rocks. All right, now 5Ks back home. We've just been noticing as we're strolling back that these clouds are coming down this mountain here, so we're kind of staying up and over the other side of this, but looks like the weather's setting in. You can't see the mountain behind us either, and that's becoming cloudy, so yeah, I think we're gonna hustle back. Well, that was a pretty incredible walk. Pretty long. It was about 10 kilometers all up. Sorry, I'm just hiding by the caravan. We're actually camping out here at the moment, which I'll show in a sec as well. There's a campground you can stay at, and that's the path right there behind me, so pretty cool. So 10k's all up. It's pretty level, like flat level, easy going. There's only a few steps. I think it was just because we had the kids on our shoulders. It was a bit tiring. So yeah, 10k's. One thing I would say though is, even if you don't want to go the full 5 kilometers to the lake, the path is so stunning. Like, I think maybe even the walk there to the lake is even more stunning than the actual lake itself. Like, the swing bridges are amazing. You follow this kind of river. There's the big lake there as well. There's another lake halfway up. So yeah, even if you've only got a kilometer in you, just jump on the track and go as far as you can. If you go to the second swing bridge and go just past it, you'll see Mount Cook. So you won't see it until you cross the second swing bridge. But yeah, you get good views of Mount Cook from the second swing bridge. So you don't need to go all the way to the third and then all the way to the lake, but amazing. Probably one of the best walks I think we've done. You know, we've been on the road, by the time you see this, we've been on the road a year in the South Island, so I reckon that was the best walk we've done so far down here, and we've done a lot of walking. So yeah, highly recommend it. I'm gonna go over to the visitor center now and just have a look around, and then I'll show you around the White Horse campground and where we're staying. Might be able to hear outside, but it's absolutely blowing a gale now, so I'm hiding inside. So the campground's pretty cool, just a whole lot of grass sites. $15 a night, an adult, so it is a bit expensive for the facilities. You know, you're getting towards campground prices there, but yeah, there's no campgrounds around here, right? So you can literally just walk up, you know, wake up, walk out, do the walk. There's another glacier, the Tasman glacier. You can do, it's an hour loop track that's just down the road, so pretty cool place to stop. It's got a big kitchen area in here. Basically just sinks, there's no cookers or anything. Picnic tables, bins, there's another block of toilets over there with another thing of bins as well, and toilets here as well. So pretty cool, you can hide in here out of the wind, but you'd have to bring your own cookers and food. There's no shops here or anything as well, but yeah, nice spot. One other thing I probably would recommend is booking this campsite online. So this is one of the dock sites you can book online. There are loads of camp spots for tenting and motorhomes, but if you're coming here in the summer or you know, in peak season, it would just pay to book online, I think. You got a bit of peace of mind because you do drive 45 minutes out of Twizel to come up here, up a valley, and there's nowhere else to stay along the way. So if you arrived here and it was full, you'd probably have to turn around and drive half an hour down the road. So yeah, hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you want to see more adventures like this and come on more adventures in our caravan around New Zealand, then hit that subscribe button. We've been on tons of cool adventures recently, Milford Sound, Doubtful Sound, some beautiful spots. So check those videos out and I'll see you in the next one. See you later.